way to win a Masters Series title for him last year. He will have tougher this year if he's going to win this.
Well, he's got a seed today, and it's about to get underway. And so far, at least, we have been quite lucky with the weather. That dark-looking cloud that was hovering earlier has moved away. Some rather less than friendly clouds gathering in the distance, but hopefully they will take a little detour and we'll get through another match unscathed. A reminder, we are interactive. Just press your red button to find out how well Martin Del Potro is getting on against Stanislas Wawrinka. The early stages of that one on court one. But here it's Robredo and Djokovic once again with Barry Cowan and Barry Mills.
Great stuff, Marcus. Thank you. Get that one out of the way straight away. The defending champion.
Sometimes you look at the matchups, styles of the players, and you think, well, the underdog in Robredo's case has a chance, but I just don't feel he has the firepower to cause an upset here, especially with the form that Djokovic is in at the moment. As I look at the two players and the way they play, I just see a better version of Djokovic in all departments.
Still just 21 years of age and still the world number three. Exit yesterday, meaning that the Serb will stay as the third highest player for a little while longer. Maybe much more, who knows, but he'll certainly want to respond if he does fall further behind, to come back and challenge, and as you were saying, better form now coming into his game. To Nadal in Monte Carlo. And two good serves to seal the opener. Similar number of wins, 27 for Djokovic so far this year, 26 for Robredo. But for the Spaniard, 19 of those have been on clay. Very much where he likes to ply his trade and has done so for much of the early part of the year.
I think the important area, Barry, is to look at Robredo in the big tournaments. Lost to Roddick in three straight sets in Australia. He retired against Murray in Indian Wells, but more of that was due to he didn't want to be outclassed or demoralised. He was 6-2, 3-love down. Lost to Dent in Miami. Lost easily to Monaco in Monte Carlo.
And although he has been ranked number five in the world, that was 2.5, approaching 3 years ago now, currently number 17. He is 26 years of age. Hanging ball taken well out of the air. At the moment, the wind seems to have died down. Angled finish on that forehand. Shot he loves to play after working his opponent as well as that.
Now, one of Rob Bredo's biggest strengths is he is a very clean striker of the ball. The difficulty for him today is going to be how many times can he hit a winner against Djokovic? You can't keep relying on Djokovic to miss. When you come into a match like this, you know, when you're playing the best players and you haven't had a win against a top 10 player since July last year, that does play on your mind. And that's been the case for Rob Bredo.
Potential here for the two finalists of 2008 to meet in the quarterfinals. Stanislas Wawrinka, last year's runner-up to Djokovic, just above him in the draw, but at the moment struggling against Juan Martín Del Potro. The Argentine is 4-1 up against the Swiss in their first set.
Well, I have to confess, Barry, someone asked me the match I did last night and I've actually forgotten who Del Potro played. It was that memorable. It took me 10 minutes to remember.
Viktor Troitsky on the receiving end. Troitsky, another serve, of course, but not of the calibre of this man.
I certainly remember the way Djokovic played Nadal in Monte Carlo, and that was some of the best tennis. I'll never forget those first three games of the third set. 35, 36 minutes they lasted.
Like Murray before him, he came off second best, obviously, to Nadal eventually there. But what do you think he showed perhaps against Nadal in that match that he could take for the future?
Oh. Well, at present, Barry, he's more equipped, or better equipped, to stay with Nadal under pressure. He feels more confident to be able to do it right from the word go. You know, he went up a break early against Nadal. You know, he was with him at the start of the third. And for Andy, and he did play great against Nadal, he did it when he was behind in the scoreline. So for Murray, the next step is to try and be able to do it against Nadal right from the word go.
Say tough for Robredo to win from so far back, but he did win the point. The miss smash.
Well, it's a bad miss. You don't often say this about any of the players in the main draw. Usually so secure overhead, but he just misjudged it. Just got the flight all wrong. That's where Robredo at times lets himself down. He just doesn't get enough balls back in play on this type of court when he returns. Hence why Roddick even beats him on a clay court. And to back up what I was saying, Robredo lost to Roddick here last year, 7-6 in the third, and Rozetsky, Greg had a win against him. That's a fine effort. 2006, first round.
Threw it in the end. 2-1 ahead.
Flu viruses can spread if you don't catch your coughs or sneezes hygienically, passing flu from person to person. Flu viruses can live on hard surfaces for several hours, making flu easy to spread. To prevent the spread of flu when you cough or sneeze, catch it in a clean tissue, bin it, and kill it by washing your hands as soon as you can. Catch it, bin it, kill it. Call 0800 1513 513 to hear the latest information on swine flu.
When you're needing a number, they never slumber. 118247. This directory, Alan.
Garden work can be tiring. Or really simple. Easy, cable-free and quick. CISO, the new cordless secateur from Bosch. Bosch, invented for life.
Perhaps they'll put the lights on shortly. It has got very dark. Not sure that he needed the sunshade for that one.
Grazie. none of them.
During Monte Carlo, Djokovic did one of his interviews with Marcus. He was talking about the forehand and how he felt he had the balance right with the amount of spin, and that really did get up to high to Rob Roto's backhand.
Feeling the pressure early, fires wide, and the break made by Djokovic.
Yeah, it's been a good start from the number three seed, and it's been a different start from Rob Roto. Just feel the way he started this match, that there's doubts in his mind of whether he can beat Djokovic or whether he can actually stay with Djokovic.
There's a sense that he's intimidated by the Serb's game. Three times Robredo has made the quarterfinals here, including last year. Very quick hand skills. Good play from Djokovic to adjust to the net cord. Drop volley back to the drop volley.
And he just has a great understanding of the game, Djokovic. Knows where to put the ball in certain positions. Play your best tennis on any surface, even more so on a clay court. You have to express yourself, and every time Rob Roto's hitting the shot, he's doubting whether it's the right shot to go for, where he needs to put the ball. It's been nothing spectacular from Djokovic, just, can I say, workmanlike.
Nicola Pietrangeli again. Present on his court. I'm watching Djokovic dominate this opening set, 4-1.
This weekend, live only on Sky Sports, European Cup Rugby semi-finals. In the Challenge Cup and in the Heineken Cup.
It's an all-Ireland.
semi-final.
Defending champions Munster face Leinster, and from the Millennium Stadium, Cardiff take on Leicester. Sponsored by Toyota, it all starts Friday 7:30 with the Heineken Cup semi-finals Saturday and Sunday, live only on Sky Sports.
Ever had that feeling that your love life is spiralling out of control? You've made a life-changing decision and promised to organise a make-or-break trip to Rome, and then, at the crucial moment when you absolutely had to book the last two remaining flights, you suddenly lost internet connection. And then you realise that was all just a bad dream.
Nobody gives you a better wireless connection than BT Total Broadband. Stay connected. Call 0800 317 316.
Change of shoes. Will that help him at all?
He's gone from the road running shoes to the serve and volley shoes. Only kidding.
You think, eh?
He's going to do a Meltzer on us.
That was good to see, wasn't it? Meltzer playing like he did, as well as he did against Gonzalez.
Debo.
So often we talk of Robredo and the too predictable way that he plays. There, moved well, balanced on the shot, and just fired it through.
Well, he's a fine mover on any surface, Djokovic. And great defending here.
Tried it again, but from way back, that's harder to make. Robredo accomplished volley.
Yeah, he's a good volley, Robredo. I always feel he should come in more. And the problem with this matchup, Djokovic just doesn't allow you to come forward because of how deep he hits his shots.
Disappointing end to a good start. As you said, the return was deep. And he tried to draw him in with a drop shot.
And Robredo almost forced to go for that shot because he's out of position. Djokovic's position is right on the baseline. It's just not his way of playing, normal way of playing.
The movement so quick, read it very well and up to the ball with great control. And he has been working hard on his fitness.
He's hired the physical trainer who used to work with Thomas Muster, so that was a good decision, and Muster light retrieving there.
Physically, it's hard to think of a player who comes much tougher than the great Austrian left-hander. Of course, Nadal up there as well. But Musta at his best was something to behold. Juan Martín Del Potro is doing his best to dismiss last year's runner-up, Stanislas Wawrinka. The Argentine has won the first set 6-2. And Wawrinka love 30 on serve in the opener of the second set.
Two chances in that rally to hit through Djokovic. Djokovic put the ball in the middle of the court, but Robredo doesn't have the way to shot. Very pleased to see Djokovic take this kind of lead.
Utmost respect for Robredo. He's been five in the world. He's won 9 titles. He's won a Masters Series in Hamburg, as the boys were saying in the studio at the beginning of the match. But he doesn't have the ability to raise his level a couple of notches. You know, he's always sort of in third gear. These top players, you know, they can play lights out tennis. That's why Robredo will struggle to beat the best. He almost has to rely on him being mentally strong and just waiting for them to have a bad match.
Started the match with one of those, and that is third double fault. I must have wanted just here whether Robredo would be able to do more, but the Spaniard had to hit it up in the end. Tough to win from there.
There's one for the crowd.
Oh.
He's actually lost a little bit of his concentration here, Djokovic. As I was saying at the beginning of the game, it's actually Ferrer, Rob Brady's biggest strength. You know, he'll just go about his business and wait for his opponent's level to drop.
Saved with some authority, Djokovic putting together a good combination of heavy hits.
Ominous sign for the rest of the tour when he's starting to play with that freedom down a break point. That belief that he had this time last year is returning.
Set point. It's not just the forehand, of course, the backhand side is strong as well. And one cross court with the topspin and then the flatter hit up the line. Earning a second set point. No contest at the moment. Half an hour gone, first set in the bag.
Mouth-watering, exotic, new mango, peach and papaya. Discover something new from Tropicana.
When cancer causes money worries, we're here. When you need to talk to someone who understands, we're here. And when you're worried about the future, we're here. At Macmillan Cancer Support, we're here for you. So that some days it's not all about cancer, it's about life. Call us on 0800 500 800 or visit macmillan.org.uk.
Right now, we know it's hard making the most of your savings. That's why at Halifax, we give you a tax-free savings rate of 3% guaranteed for a whole year. It's one less thing to worry about. A little extra help from Halifax.
Big night of boxing coming up on Saturday evening from Las Vegas. Top of the bill, Ricky Hatton versus Manny Pacquiao for the IBO light welterweight title. Now the action gets underway from 10 o'clock on Sky Box Office. For more information, go to channel 743 or call 08442. 410-888. That's channel 743 or call 08442 410-888. All that to come, but for the moment we're concentrating on the round of 16 at the Foro Italico. A little bit dark overhead, doesn't look too promising. For Tommy Robredo, set down in 31 minutes to Novak Djokovic. Into the second with the Barrys.
Bright enough from the world number three, the defending champion.
Mm.
and providing he maintains his concentration, he shouldn't have too many problems turning away Robredo today. One or two moments to the end of that first set when Djokovic just temporarily seemed to lose his focus. But Robredo managing only two winners in that opening set, 14 unforced errors. That is not going to get it done. Good stab at that, nearly got it.
Well, he missed it, Djokovic, but again, the movement out wide. Stunning. It's not often talked about that in Djokovic's game, is it? His movement from the back of the court. He is right up there with the very best. Illustrated by that last shot. Under pressure, the power to turn defence into attack. Bad error, but he has to go closer to the lines. He has to try and hit the ball harder than what he would normally, because if he doesn't, he's going to lose the point anyway.
Still for the Spaniard, Djokovic further ahead, looking to advance with plenty to spare today if it carries on like this, which he'll certainly be grateful of, take that through to the quarterfinals if he can, the winner of this match to face either Wawrinka or Del Potro. And the latest on that, Del Potro 6-2 the first set, but 2-2 in the second. Wawrinka living with the Argentine at the moment in that second set. Just looking back at Robredo's record in terms of the French Open, I mean, he has made the quarterfinals at Roland Garros three times, and it's taken some good players to stop him overall. I mean, his first visit, Kafelnikov, former champion, Agassi the following year, Albert Costa, Carlos Moya, Davidenko, and more recently Ancic, Federer and Stepanek. Against most of those, unlikely that he started as the favourite and didn't have the game to upset the odds.
Well, he's got absolutely everything from his talents, Robredo. He hangs up his racket, he can say it has been a great career. I'm sorry, we're getting into this debate again.
Look for that new word between good and great and all-time great.
Well, it's a great career for him. There's no doubt about that. Five in the world, given what he has. There's nothing exceptional. But he does more or less everything very well. And that's the reason why he just hasn't been able to break through and make a final. Get to four in the world.
Oh, that's delightful. Ends the game, but would be worth another look.
Well, there's no doubt that Djokovic is more than a great player. He is going to win more majors. That was a bit of genius, that last point. A wry smile or a grimace? And what I really like about Djokovic and his approach to matches is he stamps his authority right from the word go. Yeah, he makes life uncomfortable for you in the first 5 or 10 minutes. He takes the ball early. He looks to be aggressive, takes you out of your comfort.
The work he made there. Okay, he came off second best. Robredo had to be right up with this point to come away with it. Can't buy a serve hold today, can he? Just one so far. Only the fourth point. Robredo's won on his second serve in this match. Thank you.
I've never felt, Barry, at any stage in this match, that Rob Bredo has done more than just look to hit tennis balls. There's been no real structure to how he would win his points, and because of that, the winner's two unforced errors count high.
Eight games in a row against Robredo. Djokovic dismissing him. 3-love. Start to this match, which has continued for Djokovic, but gloomy overhead, and more fans wrapping themselves up as it gets colder here in anticipation of perhaps rain to come later. Perhaps Robredo is desperate for rain to come because nothing else seems to be helping him at the moment.
Well, even if the rain does come, the umpire might say, well, you're going to have to suffer out here. It's your easy option to come off court, because it has just been one of those nightmare performances so far from Rob Brady. He just hasn't done anything right. But Djokovic has played well.
Well, you could say, well, he was a set and 4-love down against Safin, but came back to win it. Mind you, that was Safin, not Djokovic, on the other side of the net. Tumbled, rolled over, but I think rolled the right way, didn't get anything caught up in doing that.
Well, the roll might have saved him, actually.
Now, might that unsettle him?
Thank you.
It's a heavyweight against a lightweight at the moment. Again, Djokovic putting him under pressure with the high ball to the back end.
Stroke that again with some disdain, beautifully timed, not trying for too much, but knowing he's got the gap and he's got that angle.
Well, Robredo had no idea what shot he was hitting. He was anticipating maybe the drop shot. He made his move forward, but great disguise. So many options on that back end.
Novak is good. Yeah, it's good here. See here? It's coming this way here, crossing. Yeah, it's good. Voila.
Takes it. Carlos Bernard is confirming it had clipped the line. As we see with a Hawkeye replay.
He's hit a winner.
Not what you expect from him. He didn't. He's normally very good at that, particularly on the backhand one. But one of the breaks back for Robredo, and he ends the run of games against him.
Just starting to find a little bit more rhythm from the back of the court. the confidence to go a little bit closer to the lines, which is so crucial when you're playing Djokovic. Yeah, that's just a stupid shot. It really is. 15 all, quality return. You have to pay respects to your opponent's return and either knock the ball back down the middle or go cross court, but to be able to change direction. Just a poor game, really poor game.
15 fora.
Raindrops now. Just floated away, and again, two breaks ahead in this second set, 4-1.
Hi, I'm Hugh Jackman. This is Sky Movies. Hugh Jackman's Takeover Weekend.
Exciting. Extreme. Extraordinary. Hugh Jackman presents a weekend of films with The X Factor. My Weekend.
My Movies.
Plus an interview on Alex Zane's guest list, a special on his latest movie, and the premiere of Deception.
I'll be watching.
Stay in and go to the movies with Hugh Jackman on Sky Movies.
Make my day and watch it.
TDI technology uses fuel with such precision, hardly a drop is wasted. The new, more fuel-efficient Audis.
Spots of rain, as you can see. Plenty of umbrellas up around this Stadio Pietrangeli, but Djokovic not far away from another quarter-final in Rome. And will be keen to get the job done as quickly as he can before any heavier rain interrupts proceedings. Oh, yes. A rare strike against the grain of this match. Good lob. Something happened, took it to him with a great return.
Heavy strike from Djokovic. Whether it be the backhand or, in that case, the forehand.
Wait, 15.
Good serve from Djokovic right into the body of Robredo. Determined not to drop his serve twice in succession. Fired up by doing that.
It's tough to really find anything positive for Robredo in this match. Just been one of those performances.
Slide, the extra effort. And the end result, extra good.
This is an unbelievable shot from Novak Djokovic. That approach, one of the Robredo's best shots he's hit in the match. The slide, the strength in the legs, the upper body strength as well. If you ever wanted to copy the move meant out wide. That was a shot to only dream about.
Beaten for pace, beaten all ends up. Three match points. Should have gone in the first round, goes in the third. Robredo duffed up by Djokovic, the defending champion roars on.
That's a poor performance from Robredo, but the headlines is all about Djokovic. A sublime performance, he's looking the real deal again.
He certainly is looking the real deal. That was mighty impressive. First time he's faced a seed in Rome for some time, but he dispatched her with the minimum of fuss. Dare we say it was almost a great performance. Albeit against a player who was below par today. I think Tommy Robredo would accept that. Rain just spitting a little. Wasn't a problem for Djokovic. It will be interesting to see whether they bring the players out for the next match on this court. That's Roger Federer against Radek Stepanek, of course. Let's hope so. And we'll hopefully have a word with Novak in just a few moments' time. But let's have a look at his section of the draw. He goes through to a quarter-final against either Juan Martin Del Potro or Stanislas Wawrinka, who are in action right now on court one, a match that's available via our interactive coverage. Just press your red button. Del Potro in complete control of the first set, took it comfortably, and he's had Wawrinka on the rack at times in the second. The Swiss player needed a neck rub midway through the second set, and he's been battling against break points just recently. As I say, press the red button to see the conclusion of that match. We've got Simon and Zverev later on this afternoon, and of course Stepanek and Federer scheduled in just a few moments' time. It's not often that Mark jumps out of his seat, but a couple of times during the course of that match, you were mighty impressed with the Serbinator.
He's playing great. I mean, he really was playing great. I think, to be fair to Robredo as well, he wasn't allowed to play at all today. I mean, I think it's easy to sit here and say, well, you know, had he played his best, it would have been far more competitive. But sometimes against, you know, players like Djokovic, you're not allowed to play, and he didn't allow him any time to settle. He's got some long swings, the Spaniard. Djokovic took his time away. That's one of the best performances from Djokovic this year, I think, without a shadow of a doubt.
Yeah, well, he's certainly making everybody else sit up and take notice. Alas, I think because of the rain and maybe one or two other factors, we can't speak to Novak at the moment. But what we can do is head across to Court 1, where I mentioned a few moments ago Stanislas Wawrinka was in all sorts of trouble against Juan Martin Del Potro. It's got even worse for the Swiss player, as you can see. He has now been broken in the second set, and he's in danger of being broken again. Holding on there. But this is a bit of a surprise, I would suggest, Mark.
Well, rankings-wise, it's not a surprise, but yeah, I think the ease of Del Potro's sort of seeming